Hey, what's happening, Saints? Good morning to you. It is Tuesday morning, and I'm so sorry we couldn't do live doing some stuff, but you know I'm going to get this prayer in, though, right? That's what you know. Listen, we are on the brink of Merry Christmas to everybody, to families, to friends, to everywhere, to all of you that have been so faithful, that are determined that we're going to finish strong in 2020. I just watched this great movie. It's called The Nativity Story, and of course, it's talking about the life of Jesus. And what blessed me the most is to see what it took for Mary to be able to carry Jesus and the power of Jesus all the way until the end, that she gave birth unto the end. And so I just hope I can encourage you as we're talking about finishing strong to understand that Jesus was, as we're celebrating the season, the real reason for the season, as we know, is Jesus Christ. I'm reminded of all of the prophets. Over 44 prophecies went before time, speaking about a Messiah, that Jesus was going to come. Over 44 prophecies came through scripture. I just want to share a couple of them with you. And I know you already know some of these, but I just want to share this with you. And I hope I can make a point and encourage you for the day. So the prophet, when the prophet Micah prophesied in, Micah 5 and 2, Micah said, "But you, Bethlehem Ephrathah, though you are small among clans of Judah, out of you will come from me one who will be ruler over Israel, whose origins are from old and from the ancient of times." So Micah saw something coming before time. He saw something through the quarters of time, that a Messiah, something great, something that is amongst these small clan of people, yet something great and powerful was coming out of this land of Bethlehem. Isaiah saw it in Isaiah 7. He said, "Therefore, the Lord himself will give you a sign. The virgin will conceive and give birth to a son, and we will call him Emmanuel." Isaiah, looking through again the quarters of time, which is what the prophetic gift does. It looks through the quarter of time and past time. And even though the prophet themselves may not be alive to see prophecy come to pass, it doesn't negate what they saw. And so he's looking through the quarters of time, and he sees the Savior that is being born to a virgin, and his name shall be called Emmanuel. And then we know the most common prophecy that he saw, the reason for the season, in Isaiah 9, he said, "For unto us a child is born, and unto us a son is given, and the government will be upon his shoulders, and he will be called Wonderful Counselor. He will be called Mighty God, Everlasting Father, Prince of Peace." These were all words, prophetic words, that even more are added unto that had to travel through the quarters of time before they became manifested. We know the word of God, that once God speak it, it's already gone and it can't come back. So God already spoke in time. He allowed the prophets to see this Jesus that was going to be formed out of Jesus, God, and have this sinful flesh, yet coming through, he would be a king, he would be a savior. Words traveling through the quarters of time. I hope you understand. Words that God had to speak and had to give revelation unto common men and watch them travel through the quarters of time. And then what happens? A word comes unto Mary and says, "Mary, you are highly favored among women, and you shall conceive a child, and his name shall be called Jesus." And Mary just needed to conceive a word. I hope y'all hearing me today. All she needed to do was believe and conceive a word. And so she did. And Mary said, "Be it unto me." And just that quick, all of time, all of the prophets, all of what they had seen, all of a sudden it is caught up in a woman named Mary. Good God Almighty. Prophecies, everything was caught up in one seed of a vessel, humbling herself and saying, "Yes, Lord, be it unto me." And now Mary has to carry this word full term, in spite of persecution, in spite of people believing believing that an angel really did speak to her. It was up to Mary to believe it, conceive it, and carry it full term. I just want to encourage you today that this is who we are. We finish strong. God will place a word in our spirit that had to travel through the quarters of time. God has made promises unto us. He has given prophecies over us. And this is not the time to act like COVID is not going to let it come to pass. Hallelujah. We are responsible as vessels to conceive that word, hold that word, and hold unto that word until it is made manifest in our lives. We are carriers of truth. We are carriers of the gospel of Jesus Christ. We are carriers of promises of God. So I want you to be encouraged today that your labor, your prayer is not in vain. If God have given you a word, do not be weary in your well-seasoned, in your well-doing, for God is not slack concerning his promises. He will fulfill his word. And though the vision tarry, wait for it. It's going to speak and not lie. I just want you to be encouraged in this season and know that God has a set time and appointed time for what he has promised you to come to pass. So what are we doing? We are carriers of the word. Proverbs 23:23, it says, buy the truth and sell it not. Buy it, believe it, say I own it, I own it. I bought this truth. I bought the truth about the destiny of my life. I bought the truth about the destiny of my marriage. I brought the truth about the destiny over my body, my children, my finances, my future. I bought that truth and I'm not gonna sell it. I'm gonna carry it full term. Father, in the name of Jesus, I praise you for my brothers and my sisters around the world. Father, I praise you for you have made us carriers of the truth. It's your truth, Father, and it is your truth that destroys every yoke. It is your truth that set every man free. So, Father, in the name of Jesus, I declare that the spirit of truth will abide in us and will abide with us in the mighty name of Jesus. I declare that we cancel all lying spirits over our marriage, all lying spirits over our bodies, all lying spirits over our finances in the mighty name of Jesus, all lying spirits over our businesses in the name of Jesus. Every lying spirit that says our business will fail is a liar. Every lying spirit that says our marriage will be broken is a liar. Every lying spirit that says my body will be sick is a liar in the mighty name of Jesus. But we declare your word and we declare truth over our minds and our souls. Every lying spirit that says we will commit suicide is a liar. Every lying spirit that brings on depression is a liar. And we cancel it in the mighty name of Jesus. But we declare your word that your word is peace. We buy your truth, Father, your truth that we are blessed, your truth that the end of the matter will be better than the beginning, your truth, Father. We declare over our lives that we are the head and not the tail. We declare your truth, Father, that you will supply every one of our needs. We declare your truth, Father, that never have we seen the righteous forsaken, nor his seed begging bread. We declare your truth that by your stripes, hallelujah, we are healed. We declare your truth over our minds, over our bodies, over our souls. In the mighty name of Jesus, we declare, Father, that you have come to give us life and life more abundantly. We declare, Father, that we will walk in the newness of life and in the gift of the Holy Spirit that will lead and guide us into all truth. Hallelujah. We declare your truth over our life, over our mind, over our body, over our family, over our soul in the mighty name of Jesus. And we declare your word, Father, that yea, you are with us even until the end of time. So, Father, you will strengthen us to finish strong. Father, you will strengthen us to cross over strong. You will strengthen us to walk in your newness of life. For we buy your truth and we will not sell it in the mighty name of Jesus. Father, we declare spirits of false teaching will not overtake us in the mighty name of Jesus. We declare spirits of false prophets will not overtake us in the name of Jesus. We declare demonic spirit of seduction and deceit shall not overtake us in the mighty name of Jesus, but you will give us a mind of clarity in the mighty name of Jesus, and devise and show unto us, reveal unto us wicked devices that will come to steal, kill, and destroy us. Father, in the name of Jesus, I declare victory We declare victory today. We declare the enemy shall be up under our feet today. We declare that we will walk in newness of light today. We declare that all will be well concerning us in the mighty name of Jesus. We declare that our gifts and our callings will flourish. We declare that the anointing shall be rich upon us. We declare that your spirit shall dwell within us. We declare that you will send angels to minister unto us in the mighty name of Jesus. We declare that bowed down heads will be lifted. We declare that discouraged hearts will be encouraged in the mighty name of Jesus. We declare that backsliders will be reclaimed in the mighty name of Jesus. We declare a harvest of souls. Father, 2021, we declare a harvest of souls for your glory. We declare these things, Father, and we believe you and we thank you. We thank you in Jesus' name that all will be well. We thank you, Lord, that you hear us. We thank you, Lord, that you honor our prayers. We thank you, Lord, that you see our sacrifices and that we are bringing it unto you with a cheerful heart. We thank you, Lord, for you will reward us for our seek unto you. We thank you, Lord, that we can knock and you will open up doors for us. We thank you, Lord, that we can seek you and you will make your face known unto us. We thank you, Lord. We praise you and we honor you. We give your name all the glory. We give your name all the praise, for you are great, Father. You are great within us and you are great within the earth. And your name is greatly to be praised. So today, Father, let our day be filled of praise. Let our day be filled of worship. Let our day be filled of peace in the mighty name of Jesus. May our day be filled of vision. May our day be filled of ministry in the mighty name of Jesus. Speak, Lord, and speak a word clearly unto our souls. Speak, Lord, and speak wisdom unto our heart. And we declare we will give you and you alone all the glory, all the honor, and all the praise, because you are worthy of it. In Jesus' name, amen and amen. I love you so much with the love of Jesus Christ. You're going to have a blessed day today. I know that you are. Take the Lord along with you everywhere you go. Again, thank you as always for any seed that you sow into our ministry, because truly it is keeping us afloat and letting us do what we do. I appreciate it. May God return that blessing to you 100-fold. I praise God for you, for all of our e-members. Thank you for your commitment and your faithfulness. If you don't have a church home, connect with us. Go to www.tipministries.com/e-member. We would love to connect with you. It's just somebody connecting that's going to pray with you, write you, email you, see about you. These are not canned messages. They are personal. We love you. We care about you. So today, may you have a blessed day and may you go with God today and may God go with you. Peace out.